Okay, hi everyone. So as I promised, this live is going to be about my top 10 recommendations of audiobooks and podcasts. Both of them combined together, like five of them will be audiobooks and five of them will be podcasts, which I want, which I think will be extremely beneficial if you guys listen to in order to improve your English. Hi, Bhagatir Anand, I'm sorry if I'm mispronouncing your name, but hello and thank you for joining us today. So I will be talking about how you can use these podcasts and these audiobooks in order to improve your English. Hi Kavita. Okay, so the reason why I decided to compile this list is because the first step, I have talked about this before in my previous lives as well, and I've also talked about this in my videos. The first step towards speaking good English is to listen. Listening is the first barrier that you need to cross. In fact, in all the exams that you will give, agar aapko kabhi higher education ke liye bahar jana hai, ya aap TOEFL dena cha rahe hain, ya aap IELTS dena cha rahe hain, in all of these examinations, in these international level examinations, there is always a section where you have to listen to certain passages and then give your answers, because listening is a skill. Listening, speaking, reading and writing, these are your four skills. The first skill, especially when it comes to speaking good English, is to listen. So listening is an extremely important exercise. Hi Khushi and hi Chandni Saha, that you are joining in. Thank you very much for joining us today. And as I have already said it in the title of this particular live, I will be giving you my top 10 recommendations of audiobooks and podcasts in order to improve your English. Now, sabse pehli baat hai ki listen karna ya sunna kyun zaruri hai. Now, I've talked about this before as well. Jab aap sunte hain, when you are listening to certain things, when you're listening to English pronunciations, English sentences, something which is being spoken in English, to hota ye hai ki aapka audio cortex jo hota hai, that becomes activated. Now that is the first step towards acquiring any language, because we know even when we are in our mother's womb, hamari audition ya hamara jo sunne ki kshamta hai, hamara auditory cortex hai, wo pehle se activate hota hai, and tab se hum sunna shuru karte hain. Even in the mother's womb, the embryo has been proven by after scientific observation, it has been proven that the embryo does respond to certain sounds. The embryo responds to differences in sounds as well. In fact, infants as old as 1 day old, ek din ke infants bhi pa aur ba mein difference karna unko wo jante hain, because they have heard the differentiation. If your language has the differentiation between pa and ba, these two different sounds, they still are able to differentiate between these two sounds, even a 1 day old baby. So listening capacity and shruti jo hoti hai, jisko shruti bolte hain hindi mein, ye aapki shuru ho jati hai aapke mama ke kokh mein rehne ke time se hi aapki shuru ho jati hai. So if you want to learn any language completely in its totality, you want to be fluent in it, you don't want to hesitate when you're talking about a certain topic, you don't want to fumble when you're talking about a certain topic, the first step to achieving any of that is to listen. So listening just skills hai, usko improve karne ke liye, listening skills are extremely important when it comes to your language journey, in your language journey. Now, जब आप सुनते हैं, obviously आप जो मान लीजिए आप कभी कहानी सुन रहे हैं, if you're listening to a story, obviously when you're listening to a story has certain events. Story में पहले कुछ होता है, उसके बाद कुछ होता है, उसके बाद कुछ होता है. So there are events which you are following, right? So आपकी comprehension भी engage रहती है. When you're listening to something, in order to make sense, you have to follow. कि हाँ अच्छा पहले ये हो रहा था, अब ये हो रहा है, अब वो हो रहा है. अगर आप बीच में से लिसन करना शुरू करते हैं, बीच में से सुनना शुरू करते हैं, तब ऑब्वियसली आपको कभी कभी समझ में नहीं आता, अच्छा ये कैरेक्टर कौन है, ये कहां से. जस्ट इमेजिन इफ यू आर वॉचिंग अ मूवी फ्रॉम द मिडिल, यू डोंट नो वॉट इज हैपनिंग. सो वेन यू आर लिसनिंग, यू ऑल्सो हैव टू डिवेलप योर लिसनिंग स्किल्स इन ऑर्डर टू ऑर्गेनाइज वॉट यू आर एक्चुअली हियरिंग इन योर, वॉट यू आर एक्चुअली एक्टिवली लिसनिंग. दिस इज समथिंग इस चीज को कि ध्यान लगा के सुनना और एक्चुअली डिलिबरेटली सुनने की स्किल्स को इम्प्रूव करने के लिए सुनना, दैट इज नोन एज एक्टिव लिसनिंग. सो व्हेन यू आर एक्टिवली लिसनिंग टू समथिंग, देयर आर सो मेनी ऑफ योर फैकल्टीज व्हिच आर एम्प्लॉयड इन इट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, योर लिसनिंग कॉर्टेक्स, योर ऑडियो कॉर्टेक्स इज एम्प्लॉयड इन इट. यू आर ऑल्सो कॉम्प्रिहेंडिंग वॉट इज बींग टॉक्ड अबाउट. सो योर लेफ्ट ब्रेन एंड राइट ब्रेन, बोथ दीज द हेमिस्फेयर्स ऑफ योर ब्रेन आर एंगेज्ड when you are listening, actively listening to something. Okay? So, without any further ado, so that is the first step that you need to do. That is the first step that you need to do. That is the first thing that you need to improve when you're talking about actively, when you're talking about improving your, when you're even thinking of improving your English. So, let's go ahead with the first recommendation that I have. नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, इन जो जितने भी आपके जितने भी पॉडकास्ट्स वगैरह हैं, पॉडकास्ट सुनने के लिए आपको एक स्पेशल ऐप डाउनलोड करना पड़ता है, विच इज स्पॉटिफाई. नाउ सेवरल ऑफ दीज, ऑल ऑफ दीज, प्रोबेबली ऑल ऑफ दीज पॉडकास्ट्स आर ऑल्सो अवेलेबल ऑन आईट्यून्स. हाय चोयांग चेपा, welcome to the live. We are talking about my 10 top 10 recommendations of audiobooks and podcasts in order to improve your English. Okay. So, ये सारे पॉडकास्ट जो है ये आपको iTunes पे अवेलेबल है. इट विल बी ऑल्सो अवेलेबल, दे विल बी ऑल्सो अवेलेबल ऑन Spotify. In fact, all the podcasts that I have selected, all the audiobooks I have selected are available on Spotify because that's the app that I had. And I often listen to several, in fact, I listen to all of them because, hi Kavita, do you want to be in the live or was that a mistake? If you want to be in the live, please say yes so that I can like add you later on. If not, then it's fine. Okay, so so all of these podcasts are available on Spotify. You have to download the app. The app is free. There are ads, obviously. आप लोगों ने देखा होगा कि ad free Spotify के लिए क्या करना होता है. But then that's not important. एक बार ad सुन लो और उसके बाद आगे 30 seconds का ad आता है, फिर आप अपना वो सुनते रहिए. उसके लिए आपको अलग से पैसे देने की जरूरत नहीं है. लाइक आई वुड नॉट रेकमेंड, आई डोंट हैव अ पेड प्रीमियम अकाउंट ऑफ Spotify. आई हैव द फ्री अकाउंट ऑफ Spotify. और इट डजंट स्टॉप मी फ्रॉम लिसनिंग टू द पॉडकास्ट्स व्हिच आई लाइक. ऑलराइट, सो ऑब्वियसली यू ऑल, इफ यू हैव फॉलोड मी, इफ यू फॉलो मी, यू नो दैट आई एम अ ट्रू क्राइम एंड आई एम अ थ्रिलर एंड सस्पेंस थ्रिलर एंड गोस्ट स्टोरीज फैन. बट ट्रस्ट मी, none of the recommendations that I have today have ghost stories and thrillers. In fact, someday I'll probably make a list of the top 10 true crime podcasts which I like, but that might not have a lot to do with English education, so that will be for later. For the time being, one of the first podcasts that I would recommend is English Language for Exuberance. Now, why am I recommending this English Language for Exuberance podcast? If you can see, all right. This podcast is very, it's the speaker or the person who uploads these episodes is an Indian speaker. So the accent will be very familiar to all of us. It's the accent that I speak in. It's the accent that probably you speak in. So the English, the accent will be very familiar to all of us. If you are an Indian follower, if you're an Indian viewer watching this particular live, then the accent will be very familiar to you. So yes, this is something. And plus also she also sometimes gives grammar concepts, explains grammar concepts, which I think sometimes is very essential when it comes to speaking well, because sometimes you think you are confused about a particular grammatical topic and then you want to figure out how exactly do you use it. So she uses grammatical topics and she explains grammatical topics in her episodes as well. So I think that is extremely beneficial if you are a beginner, first of all. All right. She also talks about the common mistakes that we make, the common confusions that we might have. So I think for the beginner's level and for somebody who, let's say, is confused or isn't able to understand the British accent or isn't able to understand the American accent, I think this is an extremely beneficial and extremely easy listen. So when you are actively listening, hi Sakshi, okay. So when you are actively listening, I think it is extremely beneficial. This particular podcast will be beneficial if you want to improve your English. All right. So that's the first recommendation which I have for today. English Language for Exuberance are available on Spotify. Now, once this live is over, I will be posting links. I don't think I'll be posting links because links don't work. I didn't see it work in the last post which I had of the 10 recommendations for the books. Hi, Sagar. So I probably will be posting screenshots of the titles of the podcasts. If you guys want to, you guys can go ahead and download them on Spotify and follow them on Spotify. Okay, so there are 30 episodes to English Language for Exuberance. In this particular podcast, there are 30 episodes. Each episode is around sometimes 5 minutes long, sometimes it's 15 minutes long. These are things that you can listen to while going to sleep at night, so that, because you know, at night when you are sleeping, I think, at least for me, the best ideas come at night. So when you are sleeping and when you're listening to this, you will be able, I believe that you will be able to relate to them better. You'll be able to actively listen better because there is less amount of noise in the atmosphere also when you are actually listening to these podcasts and when you'll be listening to them at night. So I think it is a good memory exercise, and I think it might also be a good listening exercise if you're doing it at night. Okay. So that was my first recommendation. The second recommendation for a podcast that we have is BBC Radio's The English We Speak. The English We Speak. Hi, VK Chiller. Hi, Masume. Welcome to the live where I'm talking about my top 10 recommendation of audiobooks and podcasts. We have reached my recommendation number 2. My second recommendation is BBC Radio's. I'll say this again. BBC Radio's The English We Speak. Now, these are very short very short audios about not just grammar topics, but sometimes a word which is native to the English speaker, to the English speaker of UK or the English speaker of England, but which probably might not, somebody who is just starting out their journey of English language might not have heard. So I think it's an extremely wonderful podcast for the beginner, and I think it's absolutely essential, Sakshi, especially for you. Please go ahead and follow the podcast, The English We Speak by BBC Radio. It's available on Spotify. It has things as simple as going down or going up something. So it will also give you the information about the usage of phrasal verbs, the usage of common usage, the colloquial usages of certain phrases and certain slangs also. So BBC, obviously, we have, like when I was growing up, hamesha ye bola jata tha BBC ki news suna karo, news even on radio or on TV aapko sunna chahiye, bachpan se ye sunte aa rahe. Now obviously radio or TV ka samay to chala gaya hai, but obviously you can listen to the podcasts when BBC comes out. The podcast which I will be talking about, another one which is extremely in fact beneficial, वो बहुत ही ज़्यादा मुझे, मतलब मैंने जब सुना था शुरुआत में तो मुझे बहुत पसंद आया था, and in fact I have recommended it to many of my students to listen to that, but that is coming a little bit later. This is perfectly for the beginner, and it will be very good also because they have 3 minute ka videos, 5 minutes ka videos. You can listen to one every morning and you can figure, if for example they also have word of the days and etc, you can decide or you can try where to use that word throughout your entire day. In fact, there was this one YouTuber which I heard kabhi maine unko bolte hue suna tha ki, in fact, one of the ways in which she was able to improve her English was to choose a word for the day, a compliment giving word. For example, she wanted to give people compliments. ठीक है, तो इसीलिए वो एक वर्ड चूज करती थी कॉम्प्लीमेंट देने के लिए. द वर्ड दैट शी गेव द एग्जाम्पल वॉज इम्पेकेबल. इम्पेकेबल का अर्थ है मतलब बहुत ही ज्यादा, इट्स लाइक अबव, इट्स वेरी गुड, इट्स एक्सलेंट, इट्स वे अबव एवरेज एंड इट्स लाइक ब्यूटिफुल. सो इम्पेकेबल इज समथिंग विच flawless, right? So she decided to use that word the entire day and she would give compliments. So wo jab compliment deti thi, jo wo interaction hota tha, us interaction se usko wo yaad hamesha rehta tha word, the word would be stuck in her brain forever. So if she used the word impeccable, she would say, wow, you look just impeccable today, your presentation was impeccable, that article was written impeccably. So wo impeccable word use karte the entire day your live sessions are impeccable. Thank you, Sagar. Thank you. Now, I hope that those who will watch this later on, or those who are watching it probably right now, they will be able to remember this word forever. So they also, the BBC Radio's podcast also sometimes gives these words, which I would suggest ki aap agar subah sunenge, to aap koshish karna din bhar ke dauran to use that word in some way or the other. And when you do that, you will remember that word. It will stay on in your subconscious and conscious. It will stay on. And then you will be able to remember that word. Aapki vocabulary bhi increase hogi. Alright? So that is my second recommendation. The English We Speak by BBC Radio. Alright? The next one is a little bit for a little bit advanced listeners who are more, let's say, at the intermediate level. Now, again, I forgot to mention something. Before you listen or before you download any of these, one of the most important steps, ma'am, you are looking impeccable today. Bas, ho gaya, Sachi. Thank you very much. अब तुम एक काम करो, तुम हर हर लाइफ में आया करो और इस तरह से मुझे कॉम्प्लीमेंट दिया करो, मैं खुश हो जाया करूंगी. एनीवे, सो आज हम बात कर रहे थे, बाय द वे एक फिल्टर भी लगा रखा है मैंने, बिकॉज आई हैड वॉश्ड माय फेस और काजल वाजल कुछ नहीं लगाया था मैंने. सो आई हैड लाइक, मैंने सोचा कि नहीं, कम से कम फिल्टर तो होगा, लगाना पड़ेगा वरना दिक्कत हो जाएगी. एनीवे, सो व्हाट आई वाज सेइंग इज, बिफोर your recommendations are impeccable. I am so glad you guys are using the word. I hope you will remember this. Remember the word at least for at least some time and forever. Like, in fact, you will use this. Use the word to give a compliment to someone else tomorrow. Isse hoga kya ki aapko ye aur bhi aage yaad rahega. In fact, choose a word every day. Make somebody's day aur khud bhi khush ho, khud bhi ek word seekho aur kisi ko kuch bhi kar do. Right? So, so before I move on to my recommendations, there's one thing which I would like to say. One of the most important things, one of the first things that you need to do when you want to improve your English is, number one, find out what is your level. Aapki understanding ya aapke English ka already present level kya hai, wo aapke liye janna bahut zyada zaruri hai, because if you know your level, it is going to help your teacher, your instructor also. It will help her or him, it will help her or him identify what kind of recommendations to give you. For example, jis tarike ki recommendations main deti hu, in fact you might have seen it in the books wala video as well. The initial recommendations were for beginners, the beach ke recommendations for advanced intermediate learners, and the last ones were for those for advanced learners, right? So it's extremely important for you to identify yourself ki aap kahan stand karte hain, where is your level. Are you a beginner in English? For example, ab beginner, intermediate, advanced kya hota hai? Jo beginner speaker hota hai, beginner English learner, English ESL learner hota hai, the beginner is able to speak, is able to make lists, theek hai, is able to talk about themselves, is able to speak mostly in the present tense. Present tense में अभी क्या हो रहा है, आंखों के सामने क्या हो रहा है, या habitual aspect, जो habitually आप क्या करते हैं. For example, I eat breakfast every morning. That's something which happens habitually. You do it every day. So those kinds of things, beginner जो है उस तरीके की बातें कर पाता है. He is able to make lists. For example, if you have to go for a holiday, what kind of things will you bring? So you are able to make lists. I'll bring toothbrush, I'll bring a bag, I'll bring makeup, I'll bring, let's say, clothes, I'll bring whatever. So you are able to make lists. So naming jo hoti hai, naming is something a beginner is able to do. So you have to identify, kya aap us level pe hain? Kya aap sirf present tense mein baat kar sakte hain? ठीक है. द सेकेंड वन इज द इंटरमीडिएट लेवल. इंटरमीडिएट में आप थोड़े पैराग्राफ लेवल पे बात कर सकते हैं, ठीक है, मे बी नॉट पैराग्राफ बट यू कैन हैव अ कॉन्वर्सेशन. यू कैन टॉक टू वन पर्सन अबाउट समथिंग दैट यू, अबाउट योर सेल्फ, अबाउट योर फैमिली, अबाउट लेट्स से अ ट्रिप दैट यू टुक. सो प्रेजेंट टेंस एंड पास्ट टेंस, अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ प्रेजेंट टेंस, पास्ट टेंस एंड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल ऑफ प्रेजेंट टेंस, ठीक है. An intermediate is also able to use the past, present, perfect. ठीक है, present perfect, present progressive, इन सब को भी intermediate का जो बंदा होता है, बच्चा होता है, speaker होता है, वो use कर पाता है. The advanced speaker is able to talk in paragraphs or passages इन एनी गिवन रैंडम टॉपिक. ठीक, एडवांस स्पीकर जो होता है उसको आप टॉपिक दे दो, अगर उसको उस विषय में आता है देन दैट पर्सन इज एबल टू टॉक एट लेंथ विदाउट फंबलिंग एंड दे आर एबल टू यूज ऑल द थ्री टेंसेज इन इंग्लिश, प्रेजेंट पास्ट एंड फ्यूचर, यू ऑल्सो देर परफेक्टिव एग्जाम्पल्स. ठीक है, सो ये आपको डिसाइड करना है कि आपका लेवल कहाँ है. इनफैक्ट देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ डायग्नोस्टिक टेस्ट अवेलेबल ऑन द इंटरनेट टू फाइंड आउट वॉट इज योर लेवल इन इंग्लिश. तो पहले आप उसको आइडेंटिफाई कर लीजिए, एंड इफ यू आर एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई वॉट लेवल यू आर इन, इफ फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेटर ऑन यू कम टू मी एंड यू से कि मैम मेरा ये लेवल है, आप क्या रेकमेंड कर सकते हैं कुछ बुक्स, देन इफ आई आस्क यू वॉट इज योर लेवल, वॉट लेवल आर यू एट, देन यू हैव टू बी एबल टू टेल मी, लेट्स से आई एम अ बिगिनर और आई एम एन इंटरमीडिएट और आई एम एन एडवांस्ड स्पीकर. All right. So that's one of the first things that you need to do in order to improve, in order to start your journey of improving English. That's something that you need to do, which is आपको identify करना है कि आपका level क्या है. ठीक है. That's why that's my cue to give you the next recommendation. My next recommendation is this podcast by Michael Levers called the Level Up English Podcast. ठीक है. Now the Level Up English Podcast, why I am recommending this, because Michael Levers is already a published author of, and he's also an online tutor, not tutor, he's an online educator of English. So wo jo hai, he basically ye thoda sa intermediate ke liye hai, because he talks more about grammar topics. ठीक है, हाउ टू टॉक अबाउट द फ्यूचर, हाउ टू टॉक अबाउट सर्टन, हाउ टू टॉक अबाउट लेट्स से अ पास्ट मीटिंग दैट यू हैव हैड. सो ये सारी इन सारी चीजों के विषय में माइकल लेवर्स बात करते हैं, एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई थिंक दिस पॉडकास्ट इज एक्सट्रीमली एसेंशियल फॉर द इंटरमीडिएट स्टूडेंट, सो दैट द स्टूडेंट इज एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड स्टूडेंट इज एबल टू क्लैरिफाई देयर ग्रामर टॉपिक्स. ठीक है, अब ये सारे द पॉडकास्ट विच आई हैव रेकमेंडेड सो फार, ऑल ऑफ देम आर डिजाइंड फॉर द इंग्लिश लर्नर. ठीक है, सो दीज आर, इसमें आप इमर्सिव एजुकेशन नहीं कर रहे हो, या इसमें आप इमर्सिव जो जिसके बारे में मैं बात करती हूँ कि अपने आप को अंग्रेजी की भाषा से सराउंड करके रखना है आपको, इफ यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड और इफ यू हैव टू इम्प्रूव योर इंग्लिश. सो ये these podcasts are not doing that. These are actually teaching you. So you are actually, this is active listening. You are actually listening to things that you need to learn. So this is active listening ka podcast. We will be talking about the immersive education or immersive experience jo hai, uske baare mein jab hum tab baat karenge, jab hum audio books ke baare mein baat karenge. Theek hai? So this is my third recommendation of your podcast, which is the Level Up English. Isme agar aap, let's say aap beginners level pe hain, then you can start, they have so many episodes, they have say 117 episodes, so aap shuru se shuru karo, episode number 1 se shuru karo. Ma'am, please share all the links. Actually kya hai na, I don't know how links work in Instagram, kyunki pichli baar jab maine books ke links diye the, the links didn't work. So I was thinking that I will just post a screenshot of all the क्या कहते हैं, ऑल द पॉडकास्ट्स व्हिच आई एम रेकमेंडिंग, आई विल शेयर द स्क्रीनशॉट्स एंड यू गाइस कैन जस्ट गो अहेड एंड डाउनलोड देम फ्रॉम स्पॉटिफाई. सिर्फ उनका वो देख लेना कि कवर जो है वो सेम है कि नहीं, एंड देन यू कैन डाउनलोड देम फॉर स्पॉटिफाई एंड फॉलो देम. हाय कुबीन, हे, लॉन्ग टाइम. ओके, सो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट माई टॉप 10 रेकमेंडेशंस फॉर ऑडियो बुक्स एंड पॉडकास्ट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इम्प्रूव योर इंग्लिश. वी आर एट रेकमेंडेशन नंबर 3 या 4 है ना शायद ये. Yeah, it's recommendation number, this was 1, this is 2, this is 3. Yeah, the Level Up English Podcast, please go ahead and follow that. It is going to be extremely essential and influencing if you are an intermediate speaker and if you have grammatical, let's say, confusions, if you think ki acha isko isme yahan kya lagaun, ye isme yahan kya hota hai, I think this podcast is going to help you a lot. So please go ahead and follow that. All right. The next one is, this one is my absolute favorite. एंड मुझे ये बहुत ज्यादा अच्छा लगता है बिकॉज इट इज एक्सट्रीमली साइंटिफिक. जो हम लोगों के इंग्लिश एज अ सेकंड लैंग्वेज है ना, इंग्लिश ESL जिसको हम लोग बोलते हैं, ESL, जैसे आई एम एन ESL टीचर, आई टीच इंग्लिश एज अ सेकंड लैंग्वेज. सेकेंड लैंग्वेज क्यों? क्योंकि आपको ऑलरेडी इंग्लिश का बहुत सारा इनपुट ऑलरेडी चारों तरफ से मिलता रहता है. इट्स नॉट अ फॉरेन लैंग्वेज फॉर यू, इट्स अ सेकेंड लैंग्वेज फॉर यू, बिकॉज यू ऑलरेडी गेट लॉट ऑफ इनपुट फ्रॉम लेट्स से म्यूजिक, फ्रॉम योर फ्रेंड्स स्पीकिंग, फ्रॉम योर पेरेंट्स स्पीकिंग. यू ऑलरेडी गेट अ लॉट ऑफ इनपुट, यू गेट इट फ्रॉम द मीडिया. सो आपको ऑलरेडी मिलता रहता है, बस आपको सीखने की देरी है, आपको समझने की, एंड देन वो करने की देरी है. राइट क्या कहते हैं उसको, स्पीक, यू वॉन्ट टू स्पीक इट बेटर. सो दैट्स वाई इंग्लिश इज अ सेकेंड लैंग्वेज, नॉट ई एफ एल, विच इज इंग्लिश इज अ फॉरेन लैंग्वेज. देयर इज अ डिफरेंस. आशु कैन यू प्लीज टेक केयर ऑफ मी. या सॉरी, मेरा सुल्तान एज यूजुअल आके मुझे बोल रहा था कि उसको कहीं जाना है या कुछ करना है. ही वॉज कंप्लेनिंग. इट्स वियर्ड, होप यू कॉल मी हुबीन. इट्स जुबीन. ओह जुबीन, बिकॉज इट्स इट्स एक्स. नो, एक्स इज प्रोनाउंस्ड एज ह इन ये. I'm a linguist, so when we have to indicate, when we have to write the sound ha in Assamese or in any other language where it is, it's called a velar fricative, the ha sound. So we use x. So I thought you wanted to write x, but you just should have used z if you want, like z if you wanted to write Zubin. But I absolutely love the name Zubin because I am from Assam and we have Zubin Garg, and there isn't an Assamese or there isn't an Assamese ka 90s kid who does not like Zubin Garg. In fact, he is so much bigger than our Arijit Singh or let's say even I wouldn't dare to say Kishore Da and Mohammad Rafi, but we love him as much as mainland Indians love Kishore Da and ye. I can see that linguist Nazi. Anyway, but yes, thank you very much for joining us, Zubin, and thank you very much for joining Akanksha also. Akanksha is coming in right now. All right. As I said, my absolute favorite recommendation and my absolute favorite podcast when it comes to English language teaching is the ESL podcast, which is the English as a Second Language podcast by the Center for Educational Development. It's the US-based Center for Educational Development. It's extremely good because it's jo hum log ka jo scientific method hum log follow karte hain as ESL teachers, you know, this immersive approach and the approach of teaching English bypass karke na, ki matlab chupa ke kahaniyon mein chupa ke, ki ye kahani hai, ye kahani suno aur kahani sunte sunte aapko angrezi pata chal jayegi, aapko angrezi samajh mein aane lag jayegi. Because you know what happens, our brain, you just have to give it to our brain, you just have to give your brain a chance. If you grow up or if you immerse yourself in the English environment, if you immerse yourself in the language, if you surround yourself in the language, there is no way that you will not learn the language in the shortest amount of time and probably itna permanently ki aap kabhi bhulogi nahi. ठीक है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई डिड अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ स्पेनिश व्हेन आई वाज इन द यूएस. स्पेनिश उस टाइम पे किया था. उस टाइम यूएस हैज सो मेनी स्पेनिश स्पीकर्स. इनफैक्ट इट इज वन ऑफ द इंग्लिश के बाद स्पेनिश सबसे ज्यादा बोली जाती है वहां पर. सो इट इज देर वर सो स्पेनिश स्पीकर्स अराउंड मी. जहां पर भी आप जाते थे, देर वर सो मेनी फूड कास्ट जहां स्पेनिश बोला जाता था. स्पेनिश फूड इज सो मच पॉपुलर ओवर देयर. सो ओवर देयर आई कुड practice my Spanish a lot, and obviously I had become very good by the end of my fellowship period. Lekin obviously 5 saal ho gaye hain aaj ki date mein. If you ask me to say a few sentences in Spanish, I will probably be at most at the beginner's level. Jis level ki main baat kar rahi, jaise for example I will be able to say what is there on my table, la mesa, but I will not be able to, let's say, talk about what I ate yesterday or what I'm going to eat tomorrow. So wo level ab nahi raha, right? So because of these reasons, it is extremely important to practice. And these things, these immersive atmospheres, these approaches that you take to the chance that you need to give your brain in order to actually learn an English, ki aap immerse karke rakho usko, apne aap wo sponge ki tarah sokta rahega, and apne aap aapko sari information, you will be able to understand, you will be able to acquire the language, not just learn it. Theek hai? Please share the live video and out of my daily data pack, and this live is, oh okay, all right, sure, absolutely, I'll share it, don't worry about that. Okay, thank you for joining in, and when you do watch it, make sure that you download and then you follow all the recommendations which I am giving, and I'm sure this is gonna help. Thank you VK Chiller for joining in. All right, so this particular podcast is very scientific, and it follows all the all the no, I wouldn't say rules, but all the latest studies which show how a learner is best able to acquire a language, best able to learn a language. So I absolutely love the ESL podcast. Please go ahead and download the ESL English as Second Language podcast, which has been developed by the Center for Educational Development. Okay? Now it's these all of the podcasts which I have mentioned, they are also available on iTunes, but there were a few iTunes ke podcasts which I did not include because they are not available on Spotify. And people are more used to learning reading on Spotify more used to learning on, sorry, listening to podcasts on Spotify than on iTunes. Just like our mother tongue. Yes, yep, absolutely. So we'll also learn our mother tongue like that. We have so much of linguistic input and then we listen for 2 years. In fact, we listen for more than 2 years because we also start listening when we are in our mother's womb. And we listen, and ultimately one day we start talking. Okay? Obviously, we don't start talking in complete full sentences because we keep on learning, we keep on correcting ourselves because that's the quickest way to learn is to make mistakes. You will not suddenly one day start speaking absolutely fluently. That's not going to happen. Okay? You're going to make mistakes and you're going to learn. So at that is what we need to do. We need to keep on practicing. We need not be afraid of making mistakes. And that's something which these podcasts also, in fact, all of them talk about. So I think it will be very, I think these will be very, very important and influential for your confidence as well, because they will tell you that it's okay to make mistakes. In fact, it is essential to make mistakes if you want to start to learn. All right. So that is my fourth recommendation, which is English as a Second Language, the ESL podcast by Center for Education and Development. Now, the last one which I'm going to recommend is again a BBC podcast. And this one is also, I just love it because this one is 6 Minute English. 6 Minute English by BBC Radio. And the पॉडकास्ट का जो डिस्क्रिप्शन होता है उसमें इतना बस लिखा हुआ है कि लर्न एंड प्रैक्टिस यूजफुल इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज फॉर एवरीडे सिचुएशंस विद द बीबीसी. अ वीकली इंस्ट्रक्शन मैनुअल फॉर सेइंग और डूइंग समथिंग इन इंग्लिश इज पब्लिश्ड एवरी थर्सडे. सो यू हैव न्यू एपिसोड्स एवरी थर्सडे. इनफैक्ट दे हैव सो मेनी एपिसोड्स राइट नाउ. बट क्या कहते हैं, दे ऑल्सो, दिस इज लाइक an immersive experience where you listen to something which is not related to English. For example, there is this one episode called How Colors Affect Us. So it talks about how colors, for example, if somebody is wearing red, they are automatically considered attractive. If somebody is wearing blue, they are calm. It's usually recommended that if, let's say, if you're going for a negotiation meeting or if you want to negotiate your salary, you should be wearing blue because blue is a calming color, and it is supposed to, it's supposed to make the person with whom you will be negotiating pliable to whatever you want. All right, I'll absolutely download it and gonna share this with my friends too. Helps them in competitive exams. They keep asking me about how to smart learn English because they think I'm good in English. Okay, good. So you can share this episode with your friends. Absolutely. All right. So like I said, this is my recommendation, the fifth recommendation for my podcast wala section, which is 6 Minute English, 6 Minute English by BBC Radio. All right. Now I want to talk about the indirect language, indirect podcasts or indirect episodes that indirect, no, the indirect understanding or indirect learning of English by actually listening to podcasts that are in English, which will help you improve your listening, improve your language, because you will be listening to correct pronunciation, you will be listening to correct grammar constructions, and your brain will be absorbing all this information and creating the connections required to speak a language fluently, in speak a language grammatically correctly. All right. So the first recommendation which I have, no, I selected all of these audiobooks. I selected them on the basis of familiarity, because it's always like I recommended in my books. It's always curiosity is something extremely important when is something which I kept in mind when I was recommending the books, because until and unless you are curious about something, you will not want to read it. You have to, the book has to be able to establish an interest in its text from the first few pages. Otherwise, somebody who, let's say, already finds English tedious will not be like flipping the pages, and will not, if they are not able to understand anything, they are not going to continue. So if that happens, obviously that's always a negative thing, and it defeats the purpose of reading the book for that indirect teaching of English that I want to be doing. All right, so that's why I selected these podcasts on the basis of the topic, on the basis of the things which I think will be very familiar to us as an Indian population, because these, when you are read, you're all, since hota hai na ki when you are already familiar with a story, जब आप ऑलरेडी फेमिलियर है, अगर उसी स्टोरी को आपको इंग्लिश में कहा जा रहा है, तो इवन इफ यू आर नॉट एबल, नॉट वेरी परफेक्टली फ्लुएंट इन इंग्लिश, और यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड द लैंग्वेज कम्प्लीटली, यू स्टिल एबल टू फॉलो, क्योंकि आपको लगता है हाँ हाँ ये हुआ था, इसके बाद ये हुआ था, इसके बाद ये हुआ था, सो यू आर स्टिल एबल टू फॉलो, राइट? उसी तरह से वेन यू आर फेमिलियर, दैट्स वाई आई सिलेक्टेड दीज स्टोरीज, बिकॉज यू विल बी फेमिलियर विद देम. सो द फर्स्ट वन विच आई सिलेक्टेड इज द एलिस इन वंडरलैंड स्टोरी. द एलिस, I'm so sorry. The Alice in Wonderland by Lewis Carroll. Lewis Carroll, it's something that we have grown up with. हम लोगों ने Alice in Wonderland बचपन से, मतलब हम लोग, मैं जब बड़ी हो रही थी तो Alice in Wonderland का एक टीवी कार्टून आता था जो हर संडे को आता था. And in fact, I used to skip my art class. इसलिए मुझे आर्ट कुछ नहीं आता है. I used to skip my art class and see Alice in Wonderland. तो Alice in Wonderland का गाना भी मुझको बहुत अच्छा, टप टप टोपी टोपी टप में जो डूबे, पल 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 माहिशी लेके अजूबे, ऐसे करके एक गाना था. So Alice in Wonderland is a wonderful book. In fact, it talks about, actually the protagonist is a young girl. It's not a children's book, by the way. It started as a children's book, but it is a classic in literature. और हम लोग जब, मैं जब BA English में कर रही थी from Indraprastha College in Delhi University, we studied this text. इसके layers upon layers of meaning है, but obviously that is not the topic of our life today. But the story is familiar and so many things happen one after the other. So I think Alice in Wonderland is a wonderful book to start if you want to. Especially for active listening purposes, because there are so many things happening, क्योंकि आप सुन भी रहे हो तो आपको notice करते रहना है कि ये हो रहा है, ये हो रहा है, ये हो रहा है, आप करते रहोगे naturally. If you have any interest in the story, then you will be following it as it advances. Okay, so that is my first recommendation in audiobook section. All right, the second one is a very interesting story. Which is a very interesting podcast called the Stories from India. Now, Stories from India, usko kehne wale jo kirdar hain, wo hai Narad Muni. So you, all of us know Narad Muni ka character, all of us know Narad Muni ke bare mein. So Narad Muni was what? He was the messenger of gods, right? Wo ek jagah, in fact, ye kehte bhi hamare udhar, agar jo ek ki baat jaake dusri jagah lagata hai, usko hum log Narad Muni bolte the. Ki yaar, ye tum bahut Narad Muni ho, tum yahan ki baat wahan karte ho, is tarike se hum log bolte the. So Narad Muni was actually the messenger of gods. So this story, this podcast is the... is narrated by the character of Narad Muni, and this is extremely, you know, it's very interesting because these are different stories from India. They have history. The Ashok ke bare mein ek story hai. There is a story about Buddha. There is a story about the various kings who have come in our country. There is a story about the freedom struggle. So stories that you will be familiar with in your life. All right. So ye sari stories hai, and obviously when you're listening to it, then. When you are listening to these stories, you are obviously, आप सुन रहे हो कि क्या बात हो रही है, क्या हो रहा है, क्या कह रहे हैं. So when you are actively listening, you are automatically, आप अपने brain को linguistic input दे रहे हो. I'm also a literature student, but my subject is Hindi and Sanskrit. साहित्य साहित्य होता है, ठीक है, और साहित्य समाज का भी दर्शन होता है. अंग्रेजी आप साहित्य पढ़ोगे तो आपको अंग्रेजी साहित्य के, अंग्रेजी समाज का दर्शन मिलेगा. हिंदी और संस्कृत से आपको यहाँ हिंदुस्तान के, जो नॉर्थ इंडिया मेजरली जहां पे हिंदी लिटरेचर या हिंदी लिटरेचर लिखा जाता था वहां की आपको छवि मिलेगी. सो साहित्य इज साहित्य, राइट. सो स्टोरीज फ्रॉम इंडिया, दैट्स वन पॉडकास्ट अगेन विच आई एम रेकमेंडिंग, विच बिकॉज इट हैज ऑल दीज, बिकॉज दे आर वेरी शॉर्ट, 17 मिनट्स टू 20 मिनट्स इस तरीके के. सम ऑफ देम आर ऑल्सो 29 मिनट्स, जो थोड़े से लंबे हैं. ये दीज आर परफेक्ट फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग, दीज आर परफेक्ट फॉर योर यू नो द सेकेंडरी इनपुट, द जो छुप छुप के अंग्रेजी सीखने वाला जो है. आपको पता नहीं, आप एक्चुअली में आप ये नहीं सोच रहे हो कि नहीं नहीं मुझे अंग्रेजी सीखनी है इसलिए मैं ये पॉडकास्ट सुन रहा हूं. नहीं, आप इंटरेस्ट से सुनते हो इसलिए आपकी अंग्रेजी ऑटोमेटिक अच्छी होती है. दिस इज वाई दिस पॉडकास्ट इज फॉर, दिस इज वाई दिस दिस पॉडकास्ट इज फॉर दैट. स्टोरीज फ्रॉम इंडिया बाय नारद मुनि. ऑब्वियसली अगेन आई विल बी पुटिंग अप अ स्क्रीनशॉट ऑफ द पॉडकास्ट इन द आफ्टर दिस लाइव इज ओवर. ऑलराइट, the next one obviously I have to recommend is Harry Potter audiobooks. Now Harry Potter audiobooks, why am I recommending the Harry Potter audiobook series is because every chapter is an episode. That makes sure that agar aap maan lo aapne ek chapter sun liya to aap so sakte ho, aap suno aur so jao, theek hai, aap suno aur usko pause karke rakh do, you can move on to the next chapter later on when you have some time. Because of that reason, because every chapter, every episode is a chapter, that's why आपको ये नहीं है कि मतलब चार छह घंटे का पूरा पॉडकास्ट है या छह घंटे का पूरा एपिसोड है, आपको बीच बीच में रुक के सुनना है. दिस पॉडकास्ट इज वंडरफुल बिकॉज यू कैन लिसन टू ऑल दीज क्लासेस, ऑल दीज एपिसोड्स अलग से सेपरेटली, एक एक करके आप सुन सकते हो एंड एक एक करके आपको इसका फायदा भी मिलेगा, ठीक है. सो हैरी पॉटर ऑडियो बुक्स, दैट इज माई नेक्स्ट रिकमेंडेशन. The other one which I have, the next recommendation, the recommendation number four in audiobook ke podcasts is the stories of Mahabharat. The stories of Mahabharat which have been narrated in English by Sudipta Bhaumik. First of all, unki awaaz bahut achhi hai, बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग आवाज है, बहुत अच्छी, मतलब प्लस ऑल्सो ही ड्रामेटाइजेस समटाइम्स विद द एपिसोड्स विच आर हैपनिंग, ही ऑल्सो ड्रामेटाइजेस देम एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द ड्रामेटाइजिंग इट इज ऑलवेज इंटरेस्टिंग व्हेन इट इज ड्रामेटाइजिंग. ऑलराइट, और ऑब्वियसली हम लोगों ने सबने महाभारत देखी है, हम लोगों ने सबने महाभारत सुनी है, हम लोग ऑलरेडी उनके इवेंट्स से, ऑलरेडी उनके किरदारों से, कैरेक्टर्स से फेमिलियर हैं. बिकॉज हम लोग कैरेक्टर्स से फेमिलियर हैं, बिकॉज हम लोग उनके कैरेक्टर्स उनके किरदारों से फेमिलियर हैं, इट इज ईजियर फॉर अस एज अ लैंग्वेज लर्नर टू कॉम्प्रीहेंड वॉट दे आर सेइंग विदाउट, लेट्स से हाथ में डिक्शनरी रखे हाथ में, विदाउट डिक्शनरी रखे हमको ईजी होता है उनको समझना, बिकॉज वी आर ऑलरेडी फेमिलियर विद द टॉपिक्स, विद द स्टोरीज दैट दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, राइट. सो इसीलिए द स्टोरीज ऑफ महाभारत इज माई नेक्स्ट रिकमेंडेशन. And obviously, Mahabharata is an interesting epic. There are so many things which are happening. There are so many characters. Isliye maan lo, let's say, agar aapko khud ko test bhi karna hai, let's say if you have been listening to the stories of Mahabharata, if you come for my one-to-one class, which is there on Fiverr, to main agar aapko podcast ka ek episode deti hu, and that will be my homework, that tell me about this particular character. And you will have to tell me about that character. और जब आप बोल रहे होंगे तो obviously आपको पता ही है उनके उस character के बारे में. So it will be easier for you to tell me, even if you have not heard the podcast. But I would obviously recommend that you hear the podcast, right? So the stories of Mahabharat is my fourth recommendation. And the final recommendation which I have for you is a podcast which I have latest. Which I have been enjoying for a very long time, and this is something which I have recommended to my advanced students as well, and this is something which I have recommended to my beginner students as well. Because pehli baat to ye hai ki, because it's an Indian, the accent is very Indian and it is very familiar, and it is easy for us to listen to it and it is easy for us to understand it. And secondly, especially in the COVID times, it was very wonderful to listen to this podcast, because it talks about beautiful places, it talks about beautiful experiences. So the podcast talks about travel. All right, the podcast's name is The Musafir Stories, India Travel Podcast. Okay, so the stories document the travels of these people, the two the two speakers of the podcast. They document their travel and the travel of others that they meet along the way and the travelers that they invite on stage, and they talk about how they have traveled all these beautiful places in India. So I think it talks, it's important to listen to the podcast because first of all, you'd know, you are aware or you are introduced to these beautiful new places. और खासकर जब वो बोलते रहते हैं ना, आई नो इट्स नॉट अ वीडियो, यू आर नॉट सीइंग अ व्लॉग एंड यू डोंट सी ऑल दीज ब्यूटिफुल प्लेसेस, बट व्हेन दे एक्सप्लेन इट, यू नो लैंग्वेज मोस्टली हम लोग कब उसको ज्यादा बोलना सीखते हैं या फिर कब कहते हैं कि बहुत अच्छा आता है, जब हम एडजेक्टिव्स यूज करना जानते हैं. ठीक है, इफ यू हैव हर्ड शशि थरूर स्पीक, वो एक सिंपल से वर्ड के लिए कितने बढ़िया अलग अलग एडजेक्टिव्स यूज कर सकते हैं. सो व्हेन यू आर एबल टू यूज डिफरेंट एडजेक्टिव्स फॉर अ सिंगल टू डिस्क्राइब समथिंग डिस्क्रिप्टिव, व्हेन योर लैंग्वेज कैन बी डिस्क्रिप्टिव इन नेचर, इट इज, यू आर कंसिडर्ड फ्लुएंट. सो दिस podcast, the Musafir podcast, it describes these places. It describes these places in a way that आपको आपकी आंखों के सामने नजर आने लग जाती है ये अलग अलग जगह. So when you, and when that happens, you have to understand that they have done a good job. When you start seeing these different areas, these different lands and states and images in front of you, you have to understand that iska matlab unhone sahi kaam kiya hai. So when they are doing it, your brain is obviously comprehending what they are saying. It's creating a world and it's also learning how to create a scene. ठीक है, कैसे किसी चीज को describe करना है ये भी आपका brain उस समय सीखता है थोड़ा unconsciously. And obviously, when you are learning something unconsciously, that stays with you forever and ever. Okay? Just like our mother tongue. So these were my 10 recommendations for audiobooks and podcasts. Please let me know if you have heard any of these before, if you want me to include any more in the next live that we will be doing. I will be obviously putting up a screenshot of all the recommendations which I have given today after the live ends in a post. It will be a carousel post, so just like scroll through and you'll find all the recommendations in together. However, please make sure that you are very, very welcome. Ebar, repeat the name Zako. Oh, okay. So my English language ka podcasts recommendations were the 6-Minute English by BBC Radio, English as a Second Language podcast by Center for Educational Development, The Level Up English podcast by Michael Levers, The English We Speak by BBC Radio, and The English Language for Exuberance by JJ. Okay? These were... Much love and respect, ma'am. Thank you. Okay, so these were my 5 podcasts for actual English learners ke liye jo podcast bane hue hain, specifically for that purpose, to learn English. And the other 5 which I recommended, which were audiobooks, which you can listen to because they are in chapters and these are actually books. And you can do, passive listening. These will not be active listening or active learning, but they will be passive learning because you will be immersing yourself in the language. The books are Alice's Adventures in Wonderland by Lewis Carroll, The Stories of Mahabharata, narrated by Sudipta Bhaumik, Stories from India, narrated by someone called Narada Muni, Harry Potter audiobooks, it's there on Spotify, the entire series, The Musafir Stories, the India Travel Podcast. Alright, so these are my top 10 recommendations of audiobooks and podcasts. Again, do let me know if you have anything that you think will be beneficial to an English learner, and I'll be sure to include that in my next recommendation video. Alright, thank you very much. So that's the end of the live for today. I'll see you guys again on Thursday probably, and on Saturday again we'll be talking with a guest. Hopefully it's going to be someone who supported me for the first time. They were the first people to ever support me as a paid partnership label. So I would be, it will be my honor to host them here on my live on Saturday. Okay, thank you very much. Bye.